some people may think that having a hysterectomy completely eradicates having endometriosis. Well, we'll be talking about that today in this video and much more. I'm Dr. Perkins. I'm a board-certified OBGYN, and it's always a pleasure giving you so much information to help you live your best life. Now, in this video, we will talk about what is endometriosis, conservative management with endometriosis versus surgical management, when hysterectomies might be helpful, as well as what risk factors after a hysterectomy that may lead to you needing further surgeries and further treatment. So let's start by talking about what is endometriosis. Well, endometriosis is a very, very challenging disease. And I say that because in the medical and research community, there is so much more to be learned about this diagnosis and the treatment of endometriosis. And so we are so far behind learning and knowing more about this disease, which really leads to people suffering for many, many years with not having enough options to help them through their pain and their problems. Endometriosis is a disease that affects the female reproductive system. It also may affect the other systems in our bodies, and I'll explain that in one view. And I'll use this model to explain to you exactly what that is like. Here is a diagram of the female reproductive structures. On the bottom here is the vagina. Right above that area is the uterus, stemming from the cervix on the bottom all the way to the top of the uterus. You have two fallopian tubes as well as two ovaries. With that, I want you to kind of focus in on the inside of the uterus. The uterus has three different layers. The outside layer is almost like the skin that covers the internal aspects of the uterus. It's very thin, and on this model, it's very white. On the inside, below the skin, is the musculature layer of the uterus. Here, in this model, it kind of looks like these red little dots that you see all over. Inside of the uterus is a space called a cavity. That cavity has another layer that is called the endometrium. It is a very, very thin layer, but it's a very important layer. In that layer, all of the glands and blood vessels that leads to you having periods are located there. With that, in pregnancy, it connects with the placenta to cause blood flow to go to a baby and a grown uterus. It also allows for periods to happen. So when you ovulate and the egg dies, a communication is sent to the uterus telling it that no pregnancy has occurred that month and for it to shed its lining in what is known as a period. This layer of the uterus should really remain on the inside layer of the uterus. In endometriosis, there are cells that are very similar to that inside lining of the uterus. Remember, this inside layer is responsible for helping bleeding and periods to occur, as well as helping pregnancy to occur. So, in endometriosis, similar glands and stroma and cells are now located outside of this inside part of the uterus. That means that they can be located anywhere else inside of your body. With that, you can have these cells on your bladder, on your bowel, on your abdominal walls, and literally you can have these cells in other parts, even like your arms or your hands or your elbow. Endometriosis can be located anywhere on the inside. As your body goes through hormonal changes that tells your system to bleed or not bleed, wherever these cells are located inside of your body, they will listen to these signals and react just as they should. For instance, when it's time for a period, those glands and stromas and cells, wherever they are in your body, will bleed just as it would with bleeding that comes out with a period. Instead, this bleeding is not in the uterus, so it's not exiting the body. It's not leaving your body at all. Instead, the blood is being collected throughout your system inside and being trapped there. And so When we diagnose endometriosis, we literally can take a look inside of your body and we can see these collections of blood being built up in multiple different places inside of your body. With that, they can be as small as like the tip of a pen, and they can be as large as a rice grain or even bigger. They can cause so much inflammation and problem inside of your system that it can cause you to have scar tissue, it can cause you to have pain, it can cause you to have a lot of other issues inside. Endometriosis, therefore, is a very difficult disease because when your periods come, your body has a magnified or intensified version of pain and bleeding and inflammation all over your body. This makes it so much more difficult to maintain and to treat and for us to find a cure, which there is none. I hope you've been learning so far as we talk about endometriosis today, and we're going to dive in more. But before we do that, go ahead and click subscribe to my channel and click that notification button or the bell so that you can know exactly when these videos are now on the platform so that you can learn and we can be stronger together. Now, if you have endometriosis, there are many different ways that we can go about treatment. Conservative treatment means that we are keeping all of your organs internal and we're not changing them in any way. Conservatively could also incorporate using pain medication, such as analgesics. You can use Motrin or Naproxen, sometimes even narcotics to help to control the pain that you get when your periods are active. Or you can have other medications as well, such as what is called GnRH agonists and antagonists to help to decrease the amount of estrogens and the activity of your hormones in your body. Outside of having these conservative measures, you have the option of having surgical management of your endometriosis. With that, you can have a hysterectomy, which literally means that you're removing your uterus. In this model here, this is another view of what your internal reproductive organs are like. If you're getting a hysterectomy, that means that we are cutting out this entire portion of your reproductive organs. This is the uterus from top to bottom. This does not incorporate the fallopian tubes, and it does not incorporate the ovaries being removed as well. Literally, we would cut right here and remove the structure. That is a hysterectomy. With that, removing the uterus may help to decrease the amount of symptoms that you are having with endometriosis. The reason being, if the uterus has two purposes, which it does, one is for pregnancy to be matured and for a baby to live and for you to give birth, and second is to have periods. And if we know that the activity of endometriosis is linked with those glands and stroma and cells from the inside of the uterus, theoretically, if you remove the uterus altogether, you'll remove the problem point. Secondly, one of the theory that leads to endometriosis occurring in your body is that we are thinking that when you are having periods, which are happening inside of the uterus, again, periods should pass the cervix and come out and exit the body. But with some people with endometriosis, the theory is that instead of periods coming out, periods are now traveling through the fallopian tube, passing the ovary and going inside of your body, not the direction that periods should go. So if you're no longer having periods because you've removed the uterus, theoretically, you're not adding more glands, more stroma, more cells to your body because you're not producing periods anymore. This will help you to prevent more endometriosis occurring, but it does not solve or cure endometriosis. And I'd like to go into that a little bit further. The reason that it does not cure endometriosis is that if you have that diagnosis of endometriosis, you already have outside of the uterus glands and cells and stroma that are similar to those inside of the uterus. They are already located by your diaphragm or your bowels or your uterus or your bladder or your bowel, your ureters, literally. They can be anywhere inside of your body. Removing the uterus only removes that one portion off your organs. It does not remove all the other cells and tissue from endometriosis located in your system. So with that, know that you will still have a diagnosis of endometriosis after a hysterectomy. You may still have symptoms of endometriosis after a hysterectomy. In fact, some people may still feel as though they're having periods. They may still feel period-like pain, even though their uterus is no longer there and they're not having periods anymore. Understanding this will help to understand why endometriosis may still be present after a hysterectomy. During a hysterectomy, your doctor may also try to remove or excise or ablate, all terms that means get rid of. They may try to get rid of all of the endometriosis locations that might be present in your system at that time, which greatly may reduce your symptoms, the way you feel, and the amount of load that the endometriosis has on your body. Sometimes you may have ovarian remnant syndrome, which is a diagnosis after a hysterectomy. That means that some tissue from the uterus has been left behind, and this doesn't necessarily mean that it was intentional, it would be intentional. And so some of these cells can be left remaining inside of your body, and they continue to be active when your hormones are still active. With that, those cells can continue to produce more inflammation, may produce additional cells that will continue to spread inside of your system. If this has happened, this may lead to you needing further surgery after hysterectomy. Just know that with endometriosis, it is a very hard disease to control. And because of that, you may often need more surgeries to help with symptoms. At all times, it is best for you to talk with your doctors and weigh what I call the risk and benefits. At each time, you want to look at what your risk is for new surgery versus the benefit of having new surgery. And once you've come to a place where the amount of pain and problems that you have with endometriosis is so much greater than the risk of surgery, then this might be a beneficial act for you. Talk to your doctors in full and be well informed. I have a wonderful, special, and free gift for you today. If you visit my website down below, you will receive a free version of my hormone balancing ebook. This ebook is called Hormones Don't Lie. And I'm really excited to offer this to you today because endometriosis is really a very hormonally active disease. In balancing our bodies and balancing our hormones, we're able to help to control that. I hope you enjoy the book. I'm Dr. Perkins. It's been a pleasure today. Thank you for being here, and I hope you've learned a lot. See you next time.